Let's go back.
Yeah.
Athletics in Nigeria. Cecilia, you were at the Making of Champions presser yesterday. What's it all about?
Yeah, I think this group of people actually trying to bring out something really interesting in Nigeria, something you've never seen before. A situation whereby they decide to go across the state geopolitical zone, Lagos, Ibadan, Enugu, Benin, to go through all that, having the best 80 athletes that they've discovered so far in different auditions across the country. And they're going to bring all of them to Lagos starting from on Thursday. So you're going to be having about close to 350 athletes that will be in Lagos from Thursday, that's October 1st, to October 3rd. And all of them will be here. And of course, they're going to have the finals. And a team of these are S International. You can see on your screen. That's Babo Akonio, who is actually championing this camp. And that's DJ Ali. You have a Gloria Alozie. Of course, it was really nice seeing her, you know, after a long time. And Francis Ubikula, and all that, the coach of Obinamitu, all of them coming together. And some of these athletes who will finally make it to the finals, of course, will have a chance to actually be in their camp. They will be tutored by them, because Francis says he's not really happy with the fact that nobody has been able to break his 200 meters.
About 1999.
I mean, it's really appalling. Of course, Gloria Alozie, you know, 100 meters hurdle, silver medalist and all that. So they're thinking, because of the fact that they actually defected the other country, naturalized for Portugal and Spain, you know, Francis Ubikula, you know his story very well.
Yeah.
And of course, Gloria, they're saying that because of that, they really, really want to produce another, you know, talent that can, you know, beat their record. So that's the aim right now. 12 athletes, that's what they aim to actually produce for the Olympics.
That's it, 12 athletes.
That's 12 athletes.
Less than a year for the Olympics. So we're just waiting to see how they can do that.
Well, all right. Wish them all the best, particularly Bambo Akane and Making of Champions, for being joined now live on the show by the champ herself, Gloria Alozie, a former Nigerian athlete, now fully involved in talent discovery and development. Good morning, Gloria, and welcome to the show.
Good morning, welcome.
Good to have you around. We know you are fully involved with the Making of Champions campaign. What's it all about?
Yeah, it's about, you know, talent discovery, catching them young, you know, so that we'll produce future champions.
At the start of the show, I was having a chat with Cecilia, and we said, yes, Gloria Alozie left the country, but she has seen reasons to come back to develop athletics in Nigeria. What were we doing back in the day when you guys enjoyed running for pride and glory of this country that we abandoned, that we should start doing again?
Yes, no, during our time, you know, we had a lot of competitions. There were lots of competitions, you know, like from different categories. We had like under typing championships. We had under 15, Yinka Fola, Wiyo. The championships, we had Pastor MK or Abiola on the 20 championship. You know, there were lots of, you know, competitions in different categories. Then we now had a school sport, and this school sport was something that, you know, we are doing something from the zonal, local level. Then we went to the zonal, we went to a state, and finally we now meet in the national level. So I don't think those things are no, they are no more available. I think that's how it happened.
Okay, definitely, you know, at that time you had so many competitions going on, and this time around it's always difficult to see that. Now, these are projects you guys are putting together. How do you intend to actually train athletes, you know, in less than 1 year to the Olympics and get one of these athletes? You're talking about 250 home-based athletes from secondary school actually put in for this competition. How are you going to pick at least one or two or three that will show that can actually get a medal for us at the Olympics?
Yeah, you know, the truth is that, you know, Nigerians, we are very strong. We have a lot of talent. So the talent is there. So the work they need now is just an encouragement, you know, training them, because, you know, it's possible for an athlete to come up, and if that person gets a good training, good encouragement, it's possible, because I believe that we have a lot of talent. And those people running out there, they are not retired, they are not. So, you know, with good training and good encouragement, like just what Pambo is doing right now, I believe we can get not maybe too many people, but at least because of the shortness of the time, it's possible to get, you know, at least one, two, or three good athletes.
All right, Gloria, let's now talk about, you know, sustainability here. I'm talking about the making of champions. How do you intend to, you know, make sure that this event, you know, comes regularly, perhaps every year or every 2 years? And what plans do you have to, you know, bring in other ex-athletes to you know, join in the program as well?
Yeah, you know, this program is being organized by the CEO of this Making of Champions, Pambo Akoni, and he's the one that is really doing a very good job because he knows what it takes, you know, what it takes to, you know, make this athlete to be in a good position. I mean, to become champion. So that's why, you know, we are here, because I believe we have experience. Francis Obipelo, Uchenne Mwedolu, and Dite Jali and I believe we have experience, and you know, Bambo is a professional. He knows what is good and what is not good. So I believe at least starting up this kind of competition, like the top sprinter Genesis, because we've had a lot of auditions, and you know, each time we keep getting new athletes, new talent, and I believe here in the Lagos finals, more people are still going to come up. We're going to have good results. And I mean, you know, the continuous of this competition, because already we've had a tour already this year. We've had three, and we're going to do the finals. So I believe that we can, you know, every year it's possible for us to be doing this kind of competition. And believe me, we're going to get many, many more talent.
Okay, now how do you guys intend to partner with Athletics Federation of Nigeria, because they are the ruling body in Nigeria for athletes? How do you intend to partner with them to bring them into it, and some of these athletes discovered can also be groomed by them and they can get to represent Nigeria?
Yeah, you know, when you're talking of partnering with Athletics Federation of obviously it's not possible to, you know, it's not possible to do this all these competitions without the Athletics Federation, because you know, Athletics Federation is just like a father to every, you know, athlete or any program that is being run by anyone. So without the Athletics Federation, it's not possible, because it's just like, you know, even though this is a private organization, you know, we are just working in sort of like to help athletes, the Athletics Federation, because actually they've been doing a lot of competition. They do the classic, they organize the movies, they make the national trials. So, you know, it's like we are just here to give a helping hand. So this federation is like our father. It's the root of everything. The federation is, you know, without this federation, we can do nothing. So we are here to, you know, like give a helping hand, nothing more.
Gloria, I want to get your opinion on the just concluded World Championships in Beijing. Team Nigeria, to an extent, struggled, but what's your professional take on it? Is that our standard?
Yeah, you know, like many people who are not professionals, or many people who, you know, who are not in, who have not been there before, you know, this competition, I mean, the World Championships that just passed, it's a world something, you know. And what I want to let the general public to know is that, you know, for us not getting a medal is not good for us. It's not good, but that is how we see it. We should have gotten a medal, but we didn't get. But what I want us to know is that, you know, these athletes that won this world championships, they are also one of the best in the world, because you know, for you to get to make the standard for the world champion, I mean, for you to run there, you must make a standard. You know, otherwise the whole world will come there, and even the youth or the master. So the award is standard. And this Nigeria athletes that went there, they were able to make the standard. So, you know, it's not easy to, you know, to because in the world level, at least some people win and some people will not win. For example, many people were in the finals. So for them to even make the standard to the World Championship is a credit. So I want them to remember that for us not winning the medal, even though it's not good, but they also try their best, because sometimes it's, you know, you go to the competition and some people make it and some people don't make it. For example, I remember what happened with the 100 meter hurdles. you know, the American here, she couldn't see me around because, you know, she beat the gun and she was killed. She was disqualified. So what I want us to understand is that we didn't win a medal not because we are not good, it's because maybe, you know, running around in the world championship sometimes is not easy. It's not easy because, you know, these athletes, they were able to make the standard for them to be there and they were able to run around. You know, sometimes when you run around, it's not easy because sometimes you get injuries, sometimes you have pains, and sometimes your body is not ready to, you know, to go maybe for the medal. So I think we are not winning medal does not mean that these athletes, they are not good. They are really good, you know, because they were able to join the best in the world. But unfortunately, we did not win the medal. So I believe that, you know, with time and maybe more competitions, we'll be able to win. So that's my own take.
All right, thank you so much, Gloria Alozie, for speaking to us this morning. And all the best with your talent discovery campaign.
Thank you.